Welcome to Beyond the Data. I'm Dr. Tanja Popovic. The topic of today's Grand Round session was measuring the impact of CDC science. Here with me is Dr. Mary Ari, who is doing exactly that, leading CDC efforts to measure the impact of our science. So Mary, let's start with a simple question. What is CDC's science impact framework?
The CDC Science Impact Framework is just a means to allow the agency to be able to measure the impact of the work that we do. As you know, the ultimate goal for us as a public health agency is really the safety and well-being of the people. So this framework allows us to be able to track retrospectively or monitor prospectively the impact of our work. It has five levels of influence within this framework: disseminating science, creating awareness, catalyzing action, effecting change, and shaping the future.
How do you define or identify each one of these levels?
So within each of these levels of influence, we have key indicators. These key indicators are not by any means new. They are well-tested indicators that are well-known to the scientific community, but we just package them within each of these spheres that we call influences to allow people to be able to put these events into the influence.
So I understand that a number of colleagues throughout the agency are now beginning to use the Science Impact Framework, and there is a substantial level of enthusiasm. Can you give us one or two examples of such use?
Yes, actually the Science Impact Framework, even though we tested, you know, mostly with from manuscripts or some research work, and even we have tested with guidelines and recommendations. Currently, we have colleagues who have written recently guidelines and recommendations that are already using it, either to plan on how to monitor, to collect the data, to be able to show those influences, or actually have that already in progress. For example, the genetic screening guidelines developed by the Center for Surveillance, Epidemiology and Laboratory Services, working together with the Association for Public Health Laboratories, they are already using this framework to be able to monitor the impact of the genetic screening guideline.
So I understand that it really is broad and can cover many different areas. What else makes it different or unique when it's compared to some other frameworks that exist out there?
Yes, it is broad, and that's part of the beauty with the framework. It allows multiple uses because of its broadness. But one of the unique things with the framework is that it's focusing on effects in real time. Essentially, rather than, I mean, just think of it for a moment. When we put out the science there, we understand what the potential impact may be, but we do not know upfront if we would actually actualize those impacts. So what this framework does is measure the effects that are occurring within the natural environment where the work is going on, what changes are happening, and that can be reported, you know, and also gives the opportunity for recalibration if things are not on the right trajectory.
And let me ask you this, is this something that only CDC scientists can use, or is it something that others outside of our agency can use?
Absolutely, anybody can use this. What it really needs is for whoever wants to use this to find the key indicators that are relevant to their area of work and fit them under those five influences, and so they'll be able to use them.
Thank you very much, Mary. Obviously, this is a very exciting project that is going to have many benefits for scientists in our agency and many other nationally and globally. Thank you all very much for joining us this time for Beyond the Data, and see you next time.